No, stop switching to the goddamn flare gun. Saving those for a special occasion. Probably a boss, more than likely. And if you're wondering, yes, that is the game that is breathing heavily for no reason. It's supposed to be spooky. Because this is a horror story. But, of course, we're playing this at 10 a.m. in the morning. Tell, like. This is why we keep the flare gun around. Fuck these birds. I'm watching you. No, go away. Right, back on up. Danger! Do not enter. All right. To me, that means definitely enter. Yeah. Expecting unwanted company, specifically of the minor variety, aka those big jackasses who are really annoying to fight. Tunnel. Got's Cauldron Light? Go to Cauldron Light. Tunnels go to Cauldron Light. Oh, okay. I get it now. Fine, we'll go to the lake. She kept calling me.
Without warning, the headache stabbed at my brain.
And the plot develops.
Help! Where are you? Help!
No! Alice? Why do I feel like this is where I was supposed to go?
I'm losing it. I gotta get out of here.
Nope. There was a manuscript here.
The hunters were big, thick-set men, confident and at home in the woods. They were feeling good. Running on beer, ghost stories, and camaraderie late into the night. It did them no good, as they were taken by the dark presence, sucked deep into a darkness far worse than any ghost story they ever told or heard.
I have an odd feeling we're getting close to the end of this chapter, because the last one was 2 hours, the one before that was an hour and a half. So, logically, this one should be over right away here. And then for the last hour of the stream, we'll probably play some PUBG. Because, I don't know. Why not?
closed doors and curtains of his grimy room at the Majestic, the local motel. Nightingale could feel the locals' eyes on him, the unrelenting pressure of their judgment. He forced it out of his mind. For all he knew, they could all be under Wake's spell already. You do what you have to do to get the job done. He took comfort from the bottle in his hand. Please, he thought, just let me get through this.
Just let him get through it. Hello. Turn around, Wick. Turn around. Whack. Wake. Bullet left in this bad boy. Coffee. Is there gonna be a puzzle?
To make my way up this mine shaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
I'd like to point out this game is not a platformer, and this kind of shit does not work very well. Somewhere around there. Shoot. Dun 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 dun. Ladder that goes to nowhere. Oh, I get it. This is a Resident Evil puzzle. Climb up to the top, kick something down, and then do it all over again. I also kind of wish I had the PC versions of Resident Evil. The first ones, not the latest ones. I have them all on PlayStation, but that don't do me no good. Because, in my opinion, I think tank controls would work better on PC than they do on console. It just sounds like it makes more sense. All chapter 8. I think we're pretty close to the end of the chapter. I don't know if I want to go up or down. I feel like from the direction of the thing, that up is the wrong direction. Which means it's the right direction. Alright.
Lightning flashed behind the windows of Cauldron Lake Lodge. Tor Anderson laughed and held the steel hammer above his head. Nurse Sinclair was trying to calm him down without success. Tor grinned madly and shouted, "My hammer's up. Here's a friendly poke from Mjolnir, wench." He brought the hammer down with all his might on Sinclair's head. "We're on a comeback tour, baby."
Trying to remember who Sinclair is. I don't know if I know that character. Also, what was I supposed to be focusing on there? Sorry. What? Alright, well, there you go, everybody. You got a scenic view of everything. Courtesy of the game deciding it wanted to focus. That's cool. It's kind of nice. I'm playing Alan Wake's for the spooks, though. Fuck your crows. Fuck your crows. Nobody likes your crows. Lights.
Oh, great. Another cable car. Just great.
So, for those who missed the last one, we were in a cable car, and the cable car got attacked by the darkness, causing the worst possible situation to occur. Him falling off and losing his gun, and then me having to rely on a CPU. No, I'm not fighting you. Rude. Oh, come on, I'm right there. Grab something, Alan. Typical Alan. Anyways. Going this way. Nope, no secrets. Oh, somebody left. Oh well. Nope.